Okay everyone, so now we are going to discuss the string handling functions. Now string handling functions, so first of all I must tell you that they are used for the string manipulation. So they are used to string manipulation. Manipulation means modifying. If you are going to modify something, means you want to copy one string to another, you want to find the length of the string, you want to take out the first four characters from the string, anything you want to do. So these functions are going to help you. That's why they are called as the string handling functions. Or some people also say that string functions or string manipulation functions, they all are same. Now to take out this string handling functions, we must have a header file. So that header file should be included, and that header file is hash include string.h. People can also ask the question like, what are the different functions which are available in the string header file? Okay, so that is the same concept. So now we are going to learn the string handling functions one by one, and the first function we are learning is the strcat. So the first function in the string handling is the strcat. Well, the name signify, we can see that strcat means string concatenation. So that is going to concatenate two strings. Now concatenate means what? Join. If I have to join two strings, that is possible with the help of this particular function. So to understand this function, I am taking one example. And first of all, you must know that, let us suppose I am declaring one character array char s1, and there we are saying, let us suppose 9, it can store the 9 values, that is equal to vary. Afterward, we are saying char s2 size is 5, and there we are saying good. Now, afterward, we are saying str cat star cat string concatenation. S1 comma S2. So if you are going to write these lines into the programming, what is going to happen? We are learning with the help of the diagrammatic representation. So let us suppose that we are executing the first line, character S1. So there S1 is declared as an array which is containing the 9 continuous memory 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is starting from 0, so it will go till 8. Now inside that we are going to enter the values. So let us suppose that the first one we are having is VERY. Then afterward we know that every string is going to end with the slash 0. Similarly, we are taking another array S2 which is having the 5 size. So it is starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And inside that we are going to place the element that is good and ending with the slash 0. Now, the next statement is star cat S1 S2. That means string 2 is going to concatenate into the string 1. So here I am using one diagram to make you understand. Let us suppose that we are taking the string 1, which is having the same size 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I can also the same diagram, but I am not taking the same diagram because I will make you understand what is going to happen actually. So we know that the vary will be the same. So vary is already there. So this part is already present. So that will be taken. Now, when we are going to concatenate, the first slash 0 will not be taken. So this slash 0 will not be taken. Afterward, it is going to take out the S2. So S2 is concatenated. So good will come here. And slash 0 will be placed at the end. So that means the slash 0 will not be taken of the strings. It is going to put the slash 0 at the end only. So string concatenation, the result will be very good. Now the answer of this particular statements will be very good. And this very good is stored in the S1. So this is the first function that we have learned. And it is not only the thing that we are taking the string array. We can also take the constants. So I'm making one example. Let us suppose that these lines I am not opting. These lines are not executed. Let us suppose. Instead of that, I am saying char . Let us suppose that these lines I am not taking, and except this line, we are taking one thing directly, that str cat string concatenate. In the bracket we are saying S1. We know that S1 is already declared as vary. S1 comma, in the double quotes we are saying bad. Now what is going to happen with this line? I will tell you with the help of one example. So I'm making diagram. We know that the very first line is executed and we have declared the S1 as the size of 9. So there is a array S1 and the size of array goes from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Because the size of array is given as 9, so it is going from 0 to 8. Now, inside that we are going to store the vary, because the vary is already stored. Afterward, the slash 0 will not be taken. But this is the constant. Bad is a constant and that is going to concatenate with the S1. So if I execute this line immediately after the first line, so bad will be added. And then afterward, slash 0. So this direct string bad, or we say that it is a constant. So constant can be concatenated with the S1 and the result will come, and that will be the very bad. So very bad is going to store inside the S1. So by this we can conclude that we can append string constant means, just like we have taken the bad, so that is the string constant, to string variable. and string variable we know that is the S1. I'm taking one more example to make you understand. Let us suppose we are saying str cat, so string concatenate S1 comma S2. Now we know that whatever the content is there in S2 will go to S1. I can also modify this line by saying one more str cat, string concatenate, comma S3. So after executing this line, whatever the content of S3 is there, that will also be coming into S1 afterward. So let us suppose that we are having S1 is having very, S2 is having good, and S3 is having bad. So the answer will be very good, bad. So this is the nested StarCat function. So by this we have learned that nested StarCat function is also functionable. So this one is called as the nested StarCat function. So now I'm going to conclude the StarCat function. So in the string, we can concatenate the two strings with the help of StarCat. And if I used to write strcat S1 comma S2, and where S1 and S2 are two character array. So in that case, we can say that we can concatenate two string variable. So here the S2 value will come there and merge with the S1. Now in the string concatenate, we can also merge the string variable with the string constant. So we can say that star cat, it is a string variable S1 and it is the string constant. So string constant can be merged with the string variable. String variable means any string array, character array. And we can also use the StarCat function one inside that. So that will become the nested string concatenation. So all these three possibilities are there with the StarCat function. And now we are going to learn the next type of string handling function, and that is the StarCMP, string compare function.